it was the 125th anniversary of Gandhi. So Gandhi used to communicate enormously by just using postcards.
Gandhi wrote postcards and always received postcards, and I'm told that he answered every postcard that he received. He had very bad handwriting, but he scribbled, so it was kind of a scribbles that he did.
Then we asked, I've forgotten the number, but 80 to 100 artists to do 6 postcards. And on his birthday, the works of each of the artists were shown simultaneously in an exhibition in 6 cities.
The act of making those postcards and then sending out those postcards or also selling them at a low price, all of this had a real sense of trying to get out there into the public.
The fact that it opened in 6 cities, the fact that it was in this, you know, small informal format, this appealed to many artists.
So when they said, would you do something? And among things that came to mind was few possessions that Gandhi had. He had his spectacles, he had his slippers, he had a holy book, he kept the Gita with him. That's all.
Postcards for Gandhi is to also bring back the ideology of Gandhiism, which was slowly sort of on the wane. Conservatism meant religiosity, religiosity meant ghettoism. And once ghettoism sets in, then you have community clashes. So in that sense, it was to keep a kind of a sense of balance and sanity about secularism.
Even Mahatma Gandhi struggled a lot to make a kind of friendship between the communities and love for fellow human beings, you know.
I'm told that the postal department in India still functions mostly, if not solely, on the sale of postcards.